What's up? Hari ini kita lagi diundang untuk acara Google for Indonesia. Acaranya seru banget. Salah satunya adalah nanti kita akan interview sama yang menciptakan YouTube, si John Hardy. Yuk, ikut yuk. Tadi ada yang menarik, yaitu ada youtube.com/creator di mana banyak menyediakan aset-aset musik apa segala macam yang bisa dikembangkan oleh para youtubers baru. Kemudian ada juga tadi akselerator di mana nanti tempat-tempat kayak kafe dan tempat-tempat tertentu disediakan sebuah alat yang namanya akselerator. Jadi pengunjungnya pada saat nonton YouTube itu langsung tanpa buffering. Yuk lanjut yuk. Baru dari YouTube, yaitu adalah YouTube Creator Hub yang katanya bisa membantu para kreator-kreator muda di Indonesia, youtuber-youtuber muda untuk mengembang lebih lagi gitu. Jadi sebenarnya saya mau langsung coba, cuma lagi nggak ada internet aja. Oke, Google. Siapa nama Presiden Indonesia sekarang?
Joko Widodo.
Kapan ulang tahunnya? Oke, Google. Kapan ulang tahunnya?
Joko Widodo lahir pada tanggal 21 Juni 1961.
Gua juga dia. Alright, sekarang sudah sama Ririn, salah satu YouTube partner manager. Kita mau ngomongin tadi ada fitur baru namanya YouTube Creator Hub, itu apa?
Jadi YouTube Creator Hub itu adalah satu website isinya untuk one stop solution buat teman-teman creator yang memang baru mulai di YouTube, udah besar di YouTube dan bahkan mau menjadi sukses di YouTube seperti kayak Edo ini.
Maksudnya apa? Apa namanya? Membantu dalam bidang apa? Apakah musik? Apa ada library atau apa?
Masak. Enggak deh. Jadi ngebantunya itu bakal jadi kalau misalnya kalian mau tahu gitu, YouTube itu sebenarnya membantu dalam artian apa? Oke, misalnya mereka butuh bantuan nih atau creator baru mulai, kira-kira ada apa aja sih yang mereka bisa dapatkan, ilmu apa? Nah, kita mempunyai juga tingkat manfaat berdasarkan subscriber level. Jadi kalau misalnya dari 0 sampai 100 itu namanya apa? Nanti bakal punya benefit seperti oh bisa punya akses ke Creator Academy misalnya, atau misalnya punya akses ke basic information tentang YouTube itu apa. Nah, nanti di website itu juga bakal ada misalnya untuk creator yang misalnya 1000 sampai 10.000 itu Opal Creator. Nanti teman-teman creator juga bisa ngelihat kalau misalnya oh udah nyampe 1000 nih bisa ikut acara eksklusifnya YouTube gitu. Misalnya ada workshop, ada temu apa loka karya juga. Jadi bisa ketemu teman-teman creator yang lain di kota-kota di Indonesia.
Nah, itu bisa diakses siapapun ya.
Bisa diakses siapapun. Jadi kalau misalnya di youtube.com/creators.
Creators. Itu dia.
Jadi jangan khawatir kalau misalnya teman-teman creator baru atau kayak teman-teman yang baru mau mulai YouTube, kalau misalnya bingung di situ ada semuanya. Kalian juga bisa lihat kalau misalnya kalian butuh support atau kayak help butuh dari teman-teman dari YouTube juga, gimana sih mungkin ada pertanyaan tentang hal-hal yang mungkin agak-agak monetisasi atau kayak pertanyaan tentang macam-macam lah, itu kalian bisa email ke support kita juga melalui website itu.
Pakai bahasa Inggris. Pakai
kalau email Inggris, cuman kalau misalnya kalian cuma mau lihat informasi sekedarnya, karena di help center kita itu banyak banget. Jadi kalian bisa langsung ke Creator Hub, langsung bakal di report di sana.
Siap. Terus satu pertanyaan yang selalu ditanyakan saya, ditanyakan sama subscriber saya, umur berapa baru bisa jadi YouTuber?
Umur kalau bisa 18 ya. Sesuai dengan ketentuan dari Google sendiri dan YouTube.
Oke, siap. Hey, what's up? Ini gue lagi pakai tracker. Tracker ini adalah alat untuk Google Maps. Apa itu? Bingung. Dan gue sedang bersama dengan Mr. Hugh. Apa kabar?
Baik-baik saja.
ini beneran berat banget. Can you explain a little bit about the tracker that I'm using right now?
Yeah, sure. So this is a tracker that we use for special collects for Street View. So you can walk around. You know, maybe you're in a national park. You know, somewhere special, and this will take photographs. I think this has got around 15 cameras in it.
So 15 cameras in one. So it's gonna be 360.
That's it. So it shoots 360 up in the air as well, so that you can pan right up into the sky.
And will be in video format or on?
No, it's
photo format.
Photo format, and then we stitch those together so that as a user of Street View, you know, you can get a continuous view of the.
So you have a lot of people that are walking around all over the country.
We do. We do. We have these trackers that you can take walking around. We have an underwater one that you can go and see marine parks, capture biodiversity. We've got a snow one.
Okay.
Lots of cars.
How do I press shoot?
You don't have to do anything. We just turn it on, and then as you walk, we capture where you are. We capture all the photos, and then we stitch those back together. So you just got to go. All you got to do is go hiking.
But how about me? Can people see me walking?
Oh yeah, they'll certainly see you. You'll look different. You'll get lots of questions. You know, people will be excited to see your mapping, and they'll want to know when
you're around. Street View. When I see the location,
yeah.
Will there be people?
No, you won't see it. It will shoot above your head. You might occasionally see a shadow of you, but I won't actually see you.
Ah, I see. So it's supposed to be man-held like this?
That's right. You just walk.
Can we mount it somewhere else? I mean, like horses. I think it's a lot a little bit more easier if you have like horses or camels.
We've actually done one on a camel.
Ah,
we have done
awesome.
We have done that. We've done camels, snowmobiles, underwater, bicycles.
It's waterproof.
It's not quite waterproof. Reasonably waterproof. We've got ones that are waterproof. This one is.
Okay.
You need to take it off.
Okay. Thank you, Hugh.
Hey, thank you.
I'll be more excited about seeing Street Views now because I know the pain of making Street Views. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Hugh. Okay.
Ayo, kita Street View Rich Carlton.
Oh my god.
Cool.
Alhamdulillah kita dapat street view makanan di Carlton. Berat banget troops. Kiri saya sakit. Gila, ternyata penderitaan untuk bikin street views, tapi memang worth it banget. Kalian bisa cek di Google Maps, bisa ada apa namanya, ada logo street viewsnya. Kalian bisa klik, kemudian kalian bisa jalan-jalan strolling around kayak pakai VR gitu. Kalian bisa kanan kiri kanan kiri, nanti ada starshotnya. Hey, what's up? Kita lagi sama Mr. John Harding as a VP of YouTube Engineer. Kemarin gue udah tanyain sama kalian di Instagram. Mau nanya apa sama Mr. John? Hari ini kita akan langsung tanya ya. The first one is from Chris Terik 10. Can you share the most ridiculous thing that you have seen in YouTube?
I think it would be the slow-mo guys crawling into like a giant 6-foot water balloon. Wow. And then popping it.
All right, awesome. So this is gonna be a quick question. From She Farms, from all Indonesian YouTuber, who is your favorite one?
It is it.
Nice question. From Rania Nayara, why YouTube's logo is red and white?
You know what? I don't know. It's just always been that way.
It doesn't symbolize anything.
I don't know. It was that way when I got there.
All right. From Sophie Paramita, what is the main reason of YouTube existence?
To enable everyone around the world to share their ideas and passions with everyone else around the world.
Awesome. From Paris Alpha, what is your original intention when YouTube is invented at the first time?
It was the same thing, to let people share their thoughts and ideas with the world.
Okay, this one is pretty quite serious. From BG_ES, what is your opinion about YouTube videos that showing inappropriate things for teenagers like pornography, sexual, racial content, and cursing, and something like that?
So we have our YouTube community guidelines, and we rely on our community to flag videos and tell us when something is inappropriate. Mm-hmm. And when they do that, then we have a team that is on standby around the clock to review those videos.
So do you have like a special team that actually scroll if it pops up in the time feed?
It's all based on our community flagging videos for us to review.
Okay. Next one is from Nico Hadi Sastrio. Why YouTube share the ads revenue to YouTube creator? Unlike social media, other social media platform, people create but they don't share revenue. Why YouTube do that?
Well, we know our creators put a lot of hard work in, and it takes a lot of energy and resources to make these videos, and we want to enable our creators to make a living with their YouTube channels. And so the only way to do that is to make sure that we're sharing the money with them.
Awesome. What is your vision and goal for YouTube in the future?
One of my focuses right now is making sure that YouTube works well for users mm-hmm. all around the world, regardless of what the infrastructure or other technical challenges they face is. And so we're putting a lot of energy into things like YouTube Offline, our accelerator, to make sure that everyone can watch YouTube, even if they're on a slow connection, or with YouTube Offline, even if they don't have a connection.
Okay, this is my personal question.
Yeah.
How do you see YouTube in 5-10 years?
Hopefully bigger, hopefully with many more creators that are able to make a living creating content on YouTube, and really fostering that rich engagement and interaction they have with their fans, being able to, as you're demonstrating here.
If there's something that, regardless of the technology that haven't even been invented, what do you want YouTube to have?
You know, really it's just allowing everybody to access it. The amount of educational material that's out there that can help children learn, that can help people with have good access to educational resources, it's so powerful. And so finding a way to make that really available to everyone. I have 2 little kids, 4 and 6. Mm-hmm. And when they have questions, I pull up YouTube and we look up videos that help them learn about the world. And it's such a powerful tool for that. And so if there's a way for us to make that available to everyone, that's what I want.
Awesome. Thank you so much, yeah. Mr. John Harding, for spending time with me.
Thank you
very much. Thank you. Itu dia jawaban-jawaban dari pertanyaan-pertanyaan kalian. Thank you for being here. Like so. Yeah. sekarang gue lagi sama si penciptanya tahu bulat. Pencipta tahu bulat. Maksud gue pencipta game dari tahu bulat ini. Halo Roman.
Halo
Roman Edwin. Edwin. Kalau saya kenapa gamenya ngeselin?
Gimana ya, ngeselin itu kan subjektif.
Biasa kejebak gitu. Kok ngeselin? So, karena kayak Flappy Bird gitu kan ngeselin tapi bikin lagi. Apa memang itu kuncinya apa enggak? gitu kan bikin orang.
Emang ada rasa penasaran ya gitu. Emang rasa penasaran kan ngebantu orang buat main balik lagi sih. Emang ada kuncinya ke sana juga.
Siap. Terus rencananya mau dikembangin lagi? Enggak cuma apa namanya? Game handphone, mungkin mau ke depannya.
Kita sih coba fokus di mobile sih. Kita senang sama ya apa Android gitu. Jadi kita emang fokus di sana dulu.
Siap. Alright, itu dia keseruan kita. Aku ketemu sama Mbak Falak ini.
Aku Vindi bukan Falak.
Ini Vindi, subscribe ya ke channelnya Mbak ini Vindi. Ini yang Vindi. Yang kemarin bikin video jadi Falak itu kan pernah jadi apa aja tuh?
Jokowi.
Terus?
Apa namanya? Bung Karno.
Jadi saya tunggu kapan jadi saya. Kacamatanya tinggal dibolongin tuh. Oke, terima kasih teman-teman udah ikutan seharian kita di acara Google for Indonesia. Thank you for being here. XOXO!